force of gravitation. Today in this topic, in radio, I'm going to discuss about the force of gravitation. What is the force of gravitation? First of all, you try to understand. It is saying this is the force of attraction. Force of attraction acting among the bodies by virtue of their masses. Whatever the bodies which have the masses, they used to attract to each other. As for example, just as my body has the mass, your body has mass, so what will happen? Both of them used to attract to each other. Means my body is going to be attracted by your body and your body is going to be attracted by my body. And this force of attraction is acting only because of the masses. This has given the name force of gravitation. Let's make it clear, more example. Just as you have seen this marker, it has also mass, my body has also mass. Then what will happen? Both of them used to attract to each other. Means marker is attracted by my body is going to be attracted by the marker. And this force has given the name force of gravitation. So we are defining it, what? The force of attraction, attraction acting among bodies by virtue of their masses is called force of gravitation. So by virtue of their masses means because of the masses. So instead of by virtue, you can write also the force of attraction acting among bodies by virtue of their masses. So because of their masses, you can replace it. Suppose that if you are feeling virtue term is the hard word here, so instead of that one, you can use the term because of. So because of their masses. Okay. And it has given the name force of gravitation. Now we know that force of gravitation means it is a type of the force which is vector quantity. It is the word vector quantity. So to define the vector, there must have the, it has the direction and magnitude. It has what? Direction and magnitude. Because to define the vector must have the direction and magnitude. So what will be the direction? It is saying, suppose that there are two bodies we have taken, body A and body B. Both of them have the masses. If they both of them have the masses, what will happen? They used to attract to each other. So you can say body A is attracted by the body B and body B is attracted by the body A. And this has given the name force of gravitation. So what will the direction? So these both bodies had the center. Both bodies has the center. You join the center of the both bodies by a straight line. You can say shortest distance. This will show the direction of the force of gravitation. It will show the direction of the what? Force of gravitation. So any two bodies you are taking, so what is the direction of the force of gravitation between them? So you join their center by their straight line. That straight line will represent the direction of the force of gravitation. But now there is the matter, don't be the confused. Suppose that if in the middle, if there is the any obstacle, then what will do? Suppose that if there is the wall, so it doesn't mean if it is the wall, there is the direction of the force of gravitation will not be the in this way. This is not the force of gravitation. Any obstacle is there, no matter, it will be act on the straight line only. Just a simple example, if you have said your body has the mass, the body of your mother has also mass. So you are in the study room, but your mother is in the kitchen or in somewhere. Then what will happen? Between your body and the mother, whatever the straight line will be, the join the straight line through their center, that straight line will show the direction of the force of gravitation. It is not matter between your and your mother's, there is a large room, the walls are there, it is not matter. Because force of gravitation doesn't depend upon their obstacle, is not going to be the affected. Okay, so it always shows on the straight line over there. The waves were on the straight line. Now, how to find the magnitude? So for the magnitude, to find out the magnitude, one law came, that is called Newton's law of gravitation. Newton's law of gravitation. So to find the magnitude of the force of gravitation, one law came, that law has given the name law of gravitation. Now let's discuss to find the magnitude of the force of gravitation. We are going to discuss about the Newton's law of gravitation. Newton's law of gravitation. So what is the Newton's law of gravitation? Suppose that there are two bodies, body A and body B. Body A and body B having the masses m1 and m2, and they are separated by the distance of the d meter from their center. Suppose that they are separated by the distance of the d meter from their center. What we have done? So there are two bodies, body A and body B, having the masses m1 and m2, and they are separated by the distance of the d meter from their center. So what Newton's law of gravitation is saying? So there is the masses, so there between them there is the force of gravitation is acting. So suppose that that force of gravitation is the F. The force of Newton's law of gravitation saying force of gravitation acting among the bodies is directly proportional to the product of their masses. Product of their masses. It means what? If you increase the mass of the any one body, force of gravitation will be the increased. Yes. Another happen, it is the inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their center. So this is the equation 1 and this is the equation 2. The force of gravitation acting between the two bodies is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. Now by combining equation 1 and 2, by combining equation 1 and 2, what we can write? We can write F is the directly proportional to the m1 into m2 by d square. To remove the proportional sign, we have to take a constant. So here we are taking constant g m1 into m2 by d square. So this is the mathematical expression where g is the what? The g is the proportional constant, means we have taken a constant to remove the proportional sign. Constant, or we are saying this is the gravitational constant. Gravitational constant, or we are saying universal gravitational constant. Universal gravitational constant. This is happened Newton's law of gravitation. So F is equal to g m1 into m2 by d square. F is equal to g m1 into m2 by d square. This is the mathematical expression of the Newton's law of gravitation. Now we are going to be the this write the its language. How can you write that one? We are going to be the explain. Now we can write the Newton's law of gravitation. It's a statement. The force of gravitation acting between two bodies is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. Distance between their centers. This is happened. A statement of the Newton's law of gravitation. In the next video, we'll discuss about the gravitational constant. We'll discuss about the word gravitational constant. Thank you.